I'm going to demonstrate the Clojure way of developing functionality, which means REPL-driven and from inside out. What does this mean? Most newcomers to Clojure tend to write code the same way they are used to. They write the blob of code, they test in the REPL that it works, and then they troubleshoot what and why it doesn't work. But the Clojure way is actually different. It is about writing the smallest possible thing you trust, you are comfortable with. It could be a single line of code, and you run that in the REPL at once, so you know it's working. And then you go on to the next tiny thing, and you build bigger functions from these tiny things that you have verified to work until you end up with the functionality that you actually need, all the time building on trusted stepping stones. So that's going from inside out, and we will see how that works. I have this web applications, which has a list of teams, and each team has some players. And I want to implement this delete selected button, which currently doesn't do anything. So when I select some players and click the button, I want to delete the players from the players list, and I also want to delete them from the team they are on. Here on the right side, we can see the data I have. So I have players, a player map with player details, and I have a team map, and each team has team players, which is a list of IDs of the players. So I want to delete them from here as well. But I don't want to deal with the UI. I don't want to be clicking this button repeatedly to verify that my functionality works. It's too slow and too much work. I want to go lower. So here is the button. When you click it, it transacts a mutation, which updates the application state atom. I could submit the mutation from the REPL, which I can open. But dealing with the mutation and the application state atom, that's still too much. I don't need it. I could do it if there actually was some problem in the mutation, but now I want to focus just on the pure transformational logic. So I want to go deeper. I want to focus on this function, which takes the state map as immutable Clojure map, removes the players and returns the map. So that's what I call zoom in on the smallest possible scope, smallest possible chunk of code that you need to have to be able to work on the problem. But before I can start implementing, I actually need a state map, right? Because that's the argument. So let's do one of the tricks for REPL-driven development and capture it. So you never use def for local state in functions, but it's perfectly okay to do this for troubleshooting and REPL-driven development. And I prefix my names with stars so it never clashes with any production code, and I know it's bad and should never be in production. So the code is loading. So now when I click the button, we should have captured the state map. And it's there. I will not delete it yet because it would mess up what ShadowCLJS is doing. The state map is a little too big to look at here. I can use some of the visual REPL tools to look at data, such as reveal or portal, or in this case, the ShadowCLJS inspect. So this is the value I sent here. It has player map from player ID to the actual player. So I will delete from here, and it says team map. With team having some players. So let's look at that. So we have that's a player map, and that's small enough to see here. And we have the teams. So I need to delete it from both, but let's start with the teams. So I guess I want something like could be this. Let me just think. What is the overall functionality? What is the shape of the solution that we want to have? So we have the state map. And yeah, we need to get the selected players first. So in case if you haven't seen it, we go back. Player ID. That's the ones that have UI checked. So we want to have and then I want to remove the players from the state map, and the players would be the ones here. And I want to delete them from teams. See, I'm not consistent with naming. So now I'm going from outside in, right? But I don't expect this function to work. I'm just trying to find out what's the shape, what are the small building blocks that I'm going to need. So let's focus on this one. It's not exactly the function I thought about making originally. Definite, and it will take the state map. Because that's the helper function we need to. That's the helper function we need to implement the delete selected thing. So first we need to go, essentially we need to iterate over all teams, and for each team we need to delete all the players that are on the team. What does it mean? We want to do something like update. And now I'm running out of names. Uh, or just give it some stupid name and you'll find a better one later. Actually, update, yeah, it can take multiple arguments, right? You can do this. This nice simple function. I think we are getting to where we want to be. And the other selected players. Our teams is mapped from team ID to player. So I guess I would use reduce over, yeah, some function teams, because that's what we have a starting point and that's what we want to return. And doesn't really make sense to iterate over selected players. I want to go over all teams. Yeah, of course. Teams. So here I would update. Teams. Update in, actually. Update in. Or maybe just now. And now, finally, I can delete from team. I have the team. As before, I don't really need to worry about the anonymous function. And I think I would just send actually all the players. So what I need here is just the IDs. I don't need everything. There's actually a reduce this one, isn't it? Let me think. No, that doesn't really help us because we don't care about values. Yep. So now we have the shape of the solution, and we will of course need to test all the parts. But I know I need this function delete from team that takes team and the selected player. So let's try that. Let's pick a team. There was some team that had multiple, that was the explorers. State map, team IDs, explorers. I did something wrong. What is it? typo, of course. And that's exactly why I need to test every tiny thing, because I make a lot of mistakes. And it has team players. Let's just start with just with that before we build anything bigger. Because I have that, and I have a team. I have a list of selected players, which let's get it from the state map. Player ID, that's the whole map. I only care about the values, and then I want to get those that are, what is it called, checked. Filter to only give me the checked ones. Ah, sorry. Now I need this threading macro. Good. And I only want the player ID. The IDs. So players 2 and 3 are selected, which is true. Okay, so let's store it for now. Good. So I have a team. Or actually, I have team players. And I want to remove all the selected players from that. So let's do that. Remove. And here we need some function. And oh, let's write it very simply. If selected players was a set, it would be easier. That's interesting. I guess I can do set. Should work. Yep. Oops. Ah, I put it inside here. I see. I need to test every tiny thing. Good, it's a set. I want to remove those players that are in the set. Alright, some I want to do this, but that's not enough because we don't. This is just the IDs, but this is idents, as they are called in full pro. So I need from each to extract just the ID. So I will first take the second element, which is this one, right? Or I could just cheat to verify that it's doing what I want. I lost player somehow. So. Yeah, so now I get just the IDs. And it's something with Clojure scripts. It works a little better in Clojure. Yep. So now I get this used to be one. Right, we have 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, and are selected. So I get a, I could just make the boolean, right, again. I think Shadow is reloading the code when I change it here, and then I just lose some vars. Remove, so only one stayed there. That's exactly what we wanted. We remove those two that were selected. But what I have is, I have a team, right? I have a team, I don't have, we have the code to remove it from the list. We just need to get to the list. So that would be update team. There's and here I essentially want this. So that comes in from the update, and I need the selected players with which I have as argument here. Okay, so just copy it in the code that we have and edit little code to get at the right thing. So let's verify that this works. Should get the same result as before. Delete from team. But now we need a team. We actually have it here. If I there. That's the team we've been working with, and we need the selected players, which we have. Do we have them still? Yes, we do. And it works. Just, I now need this to be set. I might forget to do that, so let's just verify. I'm very good at forgetting as well. So we have finished our delete from team, and now we want to verify that this works for all the teams. This is little too much code. How can we break it down? We can first test this part. Let's collapse this. I cannot do that because I'm inside the command. Okay. So we have our so let's just grab the part of the state that we want to work with. No, that's not, that's wrong name, right? It should be teams or teams map. And that's all I have. The selected players I still have. So let's verify this. Teams, the team, we have explorers. So see, I just copied the code and just replace some stuff with hard-coded values. What's undeclared now? Selected players. Ah, yes, sorry. Should be this one. And it works. Alright, and if I just look at the team itself, then I have auto pairs. So now I want to verify that the red useworks as well. Verify it works for one team, we want to see that it works for all teams. You know what, I can just simplify my life here. Select the players. I'll reload the code later to make sure I am not using any vars that only are actually defined in the REPL. So now I have everything. So let's see. Use undeclared ID. Oh yeah. You see, I need to test every little thing. Okay, explorers have only player ID 1, bikers have only player ID 4, which I think that was cyclotron is there only, and cyclotron is number 4. So let's verify that it works for multiple teams, really. Selected players. Here. So currently it's this. And cyclotron was number 4. Declared teams. Yeah. I have to find out how to do this better in Shadow Searches. Maybe it's the problem with IntelliJ that it's automatically saving my file after each change, and then Shadow picks that up and reloads the namespace, and I lose my vars. Delete from team. Oh yeah, because delete from team is only declared here. So now, yeah, explorers have only one person left, and there's nobody left in bikers. So that works as well. Good. So delete, and we can. Verify the function itself. Right. We've checked it, its body, but it errors. Okay, what now? The player teams in there. Oh yeah, I have not executed this code. And yep, we are still getting the same players removed. And before we remove them, you're kidding me. We had multiple players in both teams. Okay, so this one is working as well. And we have this one, which takes the essentially does the same thing, but takes the whole state map instead of just the teams. I will do this. Why? Yeah. This way I can evaluate the whole thing every time. It's complaining about delete players.
D delete players. Right, yeah, because that's something I have not implemented yet. So, delete players from teams in our... Actually, the code we have verified to work, we could just move out of the comment, right? Maybe we could move all of it out and... I need to move it before place where it's actually used, which is here. Actually, we had a code already to get people, the selected people. It was here, I lost it. Never mind, we will get back to it again. Do we still have state map? We do, awesome. So we took the state map. We took the player ID, we took the vars, and then we filtered those at our UI, checked. Right. This code we have also developed already. Just need to change that to state map. And this function, we have tested everything essentially, so we can verify that this works. If I run delete selected, right, on the whole, only takes the state map. Let's look what the state map looks like, or maybe just looks at the teams. Yep, there are all players, and if I run delete selected. Of course, yeah, Gitch. let's get back to here. Set. State map is not captured anymore. Okay. There is a trick to. I could capture it again, but there's another way to do it in this case. Okay, delete selected. And maybe and look at nice here. Here are the teams, and yep, the players have been removed. So now we can just go and clean up. I could implement the missing part, the delete players, but that would be just similar and nothing new. So let's leave it as an exercise for the kind listener. So that's all for today. There are some resources you can check out.
on my blog there's this page teaching where you get linked to all my videos and other teaching resources I've made. To learn more about REPL-driven development, and maybe I should actually show the code source code of this. There's the Clojure org guides. And finally, Eric Norman has a really great course, a detailed course on REPL-driven development, which I can highly recommend if you can afford it. Thank you very much and see you next time.